Hey everyone, and welcome to another CSESoc video. I'm Sam, and today I'll be taking you through the process of enrolling and registering for your classes at UNSW via the myUNSW platform, as well as providing some extra tips and resources to guide you along the way. There will be timestamps and links in the description below, so use them as you see fit to navigate through the video. Let's jump right into it. Prior to doing anything else, we want to first have an idea of what courses you are going to study and when. The official UNSW handbook is the place to go for this. You can search for your degree using the search box, which will take you to a page regarding all the information about your degree, including its duration, a brief overview for the degree, the courses you need to take, and more. Ensure that you have selected the right year, as information will change on a yearly basis. You can click on individual courses to learn more about them, in particular, noting the terms that they are offered, and if there are prerequisites to taking the course, or if they themselves are prerequisites to other courses. In the interests of time, I will unfortunately not be going over details into what courses you need to choose for your degree, as there are simply too many to cover for this video. There are some helpful links at the bottom of the handbook, which will allow you to directly get in touch with UNSW, who have some wonderful staff who will be able to help you out. With this, you must be thinking, wow, this sure is a lot to plan. If only there was a resource that showed me all this information while also allowing me to plan out my degree. Well, you're in luck. Introducing the CSESoc Circles app. Similar to the UNSW handbook, the CSESoc Circles app provides an easy interface to choose and learn everything about your degree. In addition, the CSESoc Circles app has a term planner which allows you to plan out and visualize your degree pathway term by term, while also warning you of prerequisites and other useful information. Don't feel obliged to have your entire degree planned out in full certainty just yet. Most importantly, have a solid idea for your first term and a rough idea for your second and third term in your first year. You can always change courses as necessary later in the year within certain timeframes, as we will cover in chapter 6 of this video. A quick small tip, aim to take as many foundation courses for your degree as possible in the first term. For example, if you are studying something related to computer science, such as software engineering, data science, or computer science, Comp 1511 is one such foundational course. Ask around for recommendations for your degree. Now that we've hopefully got an idea of what courses we are going to take, let's start enrolling. Before we begin, we need to get ourselves into the platform where all this magic happens. For us, this is done through the myUNSW website, which you can see on screen right now. Once you are here, you want to click Sign On, which will take you to this page. If you have not yet accepted your offer into UNSW, you will first need to do so using the New and Deferred Students link. Once your offer has been officially accepted and confirmed by UNSW, you will use the first link under Current Students and Staff to sign in, and then you can enter your username and password as prompted. Now that we have signed into myUNSW, our next step is to check our enrollment and class registration times. To do this, click on My Student Profile, followed by Enrollment Appointments under the Enrollment section on the left-hand side of the page. This page will show you the dates at which enrollments and class registrations open. Take note of the term that you are intending to register classes in on the left-hand side. For the purposes of this video, I will be looking at the summer term for 2023. Looking under the Course Enrollment Opens column, we can see that the date has already passed, as today is the 13th of December, indicating that course enrollments are already open, and similarly, class registration is also open for the summer term of 2023. Don't worry too much about the difference between course enrollment and class registration just yet, as I will touch upon them later in the video. One last thing, it is vital that you stay on top of these dates throughout your time at university, and not to rely on the dates that your friends tell you, as your times will very likely differ from everyone else in your cohort. As an extra bonus tip, try to enroll and register in classes as soon as they open, as you will sometimes find that some courses fill up very quickly. So, in order to guarantee that you get the times and classes that you want, be sure to get in quick. Once the course enrollments has opened, we can now enroll in our courses for the year. Typically, course enrollments open quite early during the previous academic year, and they open for all terms in the next year. However, still be sure to check the dates as outlined in Chapter 3. To get started, return to the main screen of myUNSW by clicking on My Student Profile if you aren't there already, and click update your enrollment right under Enrollment Appointments. Note the relevant year for your studies and choose Update Enrollment accordingly for the correct year. Before we proceed, I will first briefly explain some of the terminology used on this page. If you already know what this all means, feel free to skip ahead using the timestamps or YouTube chapters. Mode of delivery refers to how the course is going to be delivered. Following the infamous pandemic, most of the courses at UNSW are now multimodal, meaning that there are online and in-person options for delivery. A small minority may differ from this, however. Location refers to the place at which this course will be primarily delivered. For most courses, this will be at the Kensington campus, which is our main campus, although some courses may be at the various other UNSW campuses. UOC stands for Units of Credit and is what the university's academic structure is based upon. Enrolled/registered will have two little icons indicating whether you have enrolled and or registered in the course. Course enrollment refers to enrolling for the course and securing a spot in it for the term, whereas class registration is when you actually choose which classes you will take for that course and when. Class registration typically opens much closer to the start of the term you are registering for. Registration closes is the cutoff date for registering in classes for that term, and the final column shows the number of students who are currently enrolled in the course versus its capacity. With that out of the way, let's get back into enrolling. If you already know the course that you wish to take during that term, you can directly search for it using the search box as you can see on screen right now. If you are unsure of the name or course code, or you simply want to search for all the courses offered in that term, you can leave the search box blank, hit search, which will take you to a page where you can filter courses to your liking. For the purposes of this video, I will add GenL1021 and BABS 1112. I will enter them into the multiple courses field, comma separated, and hit search. Here, I will check the corresponding search results, click select courses, and now I can see that these two courses have been added to my summer term for 2023. Do note that your enrollment is still not confirmed, however, as denoted by the first warning icon under the enrolled/registered column. To confirm your enrollment, you must select the courses first, then hit confirm enrollment request. Now, you may have noticed earlier that GenL1021 was full already, which was totally not because this video is scripted. Here, myUNSW is telling me that this is the case, but there is a waitlist available. This gives me two options, to join the waitlist or to skip this action. Skipping this action will simply not confirm your enrollment request for that specific course, which would allow you to choose a different course from the previous screen. Joining the waitlist will add you into the queue for the course, and you will receive an email notification if you are the first in the queue and a position has opened up. I will select join the waitlist and continue, followed by submitting my enrollment request, before heading back to the main screen. You will notice that the first icon under the enrolled/registered column is now green, which is exactly what we want, and a wait has appeared for GenL1021. Hovering over the wait icon, we note that we are position 19 in the queue, which gives you a general idea of the interest for the course and whether or not you want to be waiting. It should also be noted that some courses do not have a waitlist, in which case you'll be left with no choice but to choose another course. Another error that you may encounter is not meeting the prerequisites for a certain course, which simply means that there are prerequisite courses that you must take first before taking the course that you have chosen. You can check these courses in the Circles app or the UNSW handbook. In such a case, you must choose a different course. You should endeavor to see green text under the enrolled column for all courses that you are not in the waitlist for. If your class registration date has not yet arrived, your job is done for the time being. Skip ahead to chapter 6 if you wish to make changes to your enrollment later. The time has come for you to finally choose your class times. How exciting! Back on the same page where you selected your courses for enrollment, you should now see a Select Classes button if the class registration has opened for that term. Doing so will bring up a calendar with a list of all the class times on the side separated by the courses at which you have chosen. The majority of courses you choose will generally have multiple types of classes, such as lectures, tutorials, labs, etc. Each of these will often have multiple options for time slots as well. You only need to select one of each type. The little blue icon next to each course will take you to a page showing more detailed information about that specific class, including all of its lesson times, teaching staff, and more. To aid in choosing the most optimal times and locations for your classes, you can use the filters at the top of the screen to filter all of the class options to your liking. If you're still confused as to what classes you need to take when, you can look into using CSESoc's Notangles app. Notangles is a simple and easy to use app that helps you see all the options for classes in a clear and concise interface. You simply enter in the courses you are taking in for the term and they will pop up on the calendar. Click and drag a certain class to show all of its available times on the calendar. Some classes may be grouped together, and click on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner of each course to bring up options for different locations too, as some times may have multiple of the same class occurring in different locations, including online. You can also use the auto timetable feature to let Notangles automatically generate an ideal timetable for you based on your preferences. Once you have finished using Notangles, be sure to cross-check on the myUNSW site and ensure that all class times and options line up as you expected. Despite the best efforts of those behind CSESoc's apps, they are not official UNSW websites and thus cannot guarantee reliability and accuracy of the data. If all your classes have been selected and you are happy, click Select Classes in the lower right corner. If all is done correctly, you should see a new Show Classes option under each of your courses. Clicking on that will reveal the classes which you have chosen, which you should confirm once again matches with what you have chosen. If all looks good, select the course and click Confirm Enrollment Request in the lower right hand corner. Returning to the main course enrollment page, you should now be greeted with two green ticks, meaning that you have successfully enrolled and registered for that course. Congratulations! Of course, there may be times when some things go wrong. Most of the time, the myUNSW page is quite helpful in telling you what has gone wrong, but I will quickly outline some of the most common that you may encounter. If you have missed selecting a certain class when registering for classes, this error will occur. Ensure that you select all of the options that the error states you are missing before proceeding again. If a class you are trying to register for is full, similar to enrolling for a course, there may be a waitlist available. Most of the time, however, it may be a better option to simply select another time for that class if it is available. If you notice two classes being highlighted in red, this means that they are clashing. You should seek to avoid clashing classes by moving classes around. If there is no viable alternative with your courses, contact UNSW for support and you may be permitted to have that clash on your timetable. In some cases, as demonstrated here in Notangles, you may notice that although two classes are clashing, it is highlighted in orange. This is a permitted clash and although not ideal, means that you can proceed with the enrollment. In most circumstances, this occurs when a lecture and a tutorial slash lab clash, particularly when an online stream of the lecture is available, as you can simply catch yourself up on lectures through that medium. You can find more information regarding in-person versus hybrid classes in our enrollment guide, link in description. Some courses may require you to choose your exam time as well. While for the most part this is quite out of your control, if you wish to put your exams earlier or later, you can do so by looking at the different times offered if they're available. Additionally, you may wish to coordinate classes with your friends, particularly if you are going to be working on a group project. Be sure to coordinate with the class number slash code rather than the time of the class itself, as once again there are often multiple of the same class running concurrently. You should endeavor to see two green ticks for each of the courses you will be taking in that term by the end of this. If so, congratulations, you are all done and dusted. You can use the View Timetable button to view your timetable and confirm that everything is as you expect. If for any reason you are unhappy about your choice of classes, no worries, you can still make changes to your enrollment. If you wish to swap or drop courses you have enrolled for, you can use the relevant buttons to do so, and you can go through the same process from before to choose a new course. Do note, however, that UNSW has a census date, which is typically around the middle of each term. This is the last day that you can withdraw from a course without financial penalty. Although you can drop a course at any point in the term, if you do so after the census date, you will have to pay the course fee. You can find the UNSW census dates here. If you wish to change class times, you can do so by clicking Select Classes and choosing the new class time that you wish to take. Don't forget to confirm the enrollment request once again after selecting the new class. Do note that once the registration closes date has passed, you can no longer change your class times for that term. We made it! Hopefully this guide was helpful in getting you started at UNSW. All the resources and links mentioned in this video you can find in the description box below, and don't forget to check out some of the other amazing content that CSESoc Media has to offer on our YouTube channel and website. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments below, or you can also directly email UNSW's support team. This has been Sam on behalf of the CSESoc Media team, and I will catch you in the next one.